Welcome to the Queen Ballers Club Pro Move Series. Court is in session.
Candace Parker locked down the Defensive Player of the Year award in 2020. With block shots, steals, and rebounds, we're talking a career average of 7 defensive rebounds per game. She has the complete defensive package. So today we're going to take a look at her defensive bag. We'll dig into her active hands, help defense, pick and roll defense, and much more. Candace's hands are always ready. Watch how high she has her right arm up to cut off the shot, forcing the pass, which she's then able to pick off. Here, Candace aggressively slides, beating the offense into position every way, which gives her the angle to sneak around and pick her pocket. Candace also makes great reads when it comes to help defense. Candace cuts off the passing lane while causing problems for the guard here. Then she ensures she keeps the offense on her back while applying pressure to a shot from another player with arms straight up. Notice she does not leave the ground and does not get a foul called. She gets the rebound by using her length. She knows when to pop the double. The offense can be easily trapped baseline, so she closes out with both arms straight up, again not leaving her feet and not leaning over, so there's no foul. Even without strong positioning, she's able to get the rebound by being quick with her hands. Candace cuts off the passing angle, keeping an eye on the ball and her offensive player at all times. When Candace sees Skylar Diggins-Smith slip by and make a cut towards the basket, she leaves Brittany Griner open because she's less of a percentage threat since she's backed up to the foul line. Candace meets Skylar by the basket by shuffling at an ankle, not straight on, so there's no possible charge call. In reading that she's going to go up with her left, she quickly extends her right arm to block the shot. Candace owns the paint. She's always ready to cut off the line when the offense slips by the first line of defense. She begins the closeout while keeping the angle to make the dish pass tricky. But Candace tracks the lob and gets back with quick footwork. Candace reads that Hamby is calling for the ball and rushes to help. By taking away all Hamby's space with their arms extended straight up and forcing her to the baseline, Candace is able to get a clean block. It's the timing, it's the straight arms up, it's the energy that says not in my house, it's the whole defensive package. Candace sees the offense calling with her left arm, so Candace closes out with her right. This time she strips the shooter of the ball on the block and transitions right into offense. Make your defense your offense. Candace can also shut down guards with her help defense, especially if there's no pick and roll to pull her away. Here she lets Arike think she's in the clear and then goes right arm straight up and gets the block. It's too easy. When Candace's player clears the lane, she anticipates the drive and slides into position. Candace keeps her eye on the ball even when her player is beyond the three. The key here was her timing. Candace runs the whole floor, tracking the ball, so she's ready to stop the drive, but then reads that the ball is being swung around and closes out quickly to get the swat. She's able to block because she jumps. Ideally, she would have used her left arm straight up, though, because the shooter is using her right for the better, faster angle. Hard to complain when you get a block like this that potentially changes the entire momentum of the game. Candace is an expert at reading the pick and roll. She reads the double screen and immediately closes out by moving her body as absolutely close to the offense as possible, blocking the shooter's view. Rather than wait for the offense to come to her, with the shot clock at 5, Candace steps up and takes the shot away. Notice how Candace stays big, taking up the lane with arms wide and in the line of the pass. Candace knows her teammate's going to try to go over the screen and watches for her to get stuck. Anticipating this, she's able to close out on the shot. Candace is always ready to pick up the shooter, even all the way up by the foul line. Here she just stunts at the offense because she knows Brianna is nearby and is the real threat percentage-wise, then rushes back to Brianna to interfere. One-on-one, Candace is hard to get around. She gets strong positioning and has her left arm on Brianna's waist pushing her away while taking away the shot with a strong extended right arm. Brianna tries a step-back fade, but Candace uses quick footwork to stay with her and eat up the space. Candace tracks Brianna as she makes a cut. She gets hung up on an offensive screen for a beat, but she's sure to stay basket side, meeting the shot. Hustle and staying mentally in it was the key. On the post up, Candace only extends an arm on the offense's back, not an elbow, so the offense doesn't quite know which way to spin. Here, Candace lays on the offense to make it heavy and push her out, then goes straight up and stays planted on the ground. Candace wins by keeping her feet firmly planted wide, taking up as much space as possible, arms up and done. Candace can also bait the offense into taking a bad angle shot by creating an angle in her positioning. Candace's keys to making defense happen. Get as close as possible. Marry that player. Keep your feet constantly moving, applying nonstop pressure. Own the lane. Let it be known anyone who comes into it is going to have to go through you. Close out with body and arms straight up. Force the drive baseline by beating the offense to the spot. Extend for the rebound. This is one WNBA player whose length on defense is only rivaled by her long list of steals. See what we did there?
Ball is life. Visit queenballers.club.